Welcome to Analytics with Nax. In this video, we're going to see how to change Excel source to database tables in Power BI. Or if you are looking for how to change existing connection type in Power BI, then this is the video for you. Either it can be a file or Excel or database. So currently we have this report. Now, we have created this report earlier, that is using YTD 16, 17, 18, and we don't have data for 19. So assuming this particular report has created from an Excel source. So let me show it to you. Now you see here, this is V13 MTD QTD YTD Excel SX. So this report is created based on the Excel file. Okay, entire report. Now let me show the data for it. So from that Excel, I'm getting the sales data as well as product master, and this dim date is derived in the M query. Okay, I'm not sure about this table. Let me delete it. That's fine. So let's hit that one. Okay, this is fine. So now these two tables, I want to replace it with the database, and this is derived from mQuery, as I told before. So how to do that? And this is not the video, like if you want to change to different source file, I mean to say, instead of this file you want to change it to another file, you can do it here, right? If you go to the change source, then what will happen? Let us see that. So when you click on this, it will prompt you to change another file. See, there is no option, even I go to advanced, there is no option to convert it as a database source. Basically, this option works fine, like when you want to change this source file, that I have created a separate video for it. So basically, we are not supposed to do that. So where we need to change the existing connection type to another connection type, that is source type itself. For that, we need to go to, as usual, Power Query. So in Power Query editor, we have these two tables, right? Let me show the code for sales. So for that, you can click on advanced editor, click on that sales and go to advanced editor. You'll find the code here. So source equal to Excel source, and you do lot of transformation here. Similarly, for product master also, you have some code. It is again, it is from the Excel source and lot of transformation. I mean, some kind of transformation you did. If you see the dim date, it is written it in mQuery. The code is itself written over here. Okay, this is the internal table of Power BI. That's fine. Now, heading back to our topic, I want to replace these two tables from the Excel into database. Instead of directly changing it to Excel, I mean database, by replacing it here, what I need to do is, actually I need to replace this code, okay? The entire code, not this one. So the sales table entire code, okay? But I'm very poor in writing mQuery. I mean, people can't write exactly there by replacing all the columns here. What I would like to suggest is that let us try to get these two tables from the database, and we'll create two new tables. Okay, then let's see how can we replace this entire content. We will take the content from the new tables created and replace it here, so that our work becomes simple. Let us do that. So I'll go to new source, SQL Server. Assuming my new source or replacing source is database, put my server name, and don't want to give the database here. If you know the database, just provide that. Otherwise, in my next step, I'm going to give that database name. So here I will get a list of database in this server. So that is my NagaStore. Expand this database. So when you expand it, it will list you the list of tables. I want these two tables. Okay, so let us click on this and click OK. So now we got these two tables, sales data and product table. So what code it has generated? Let us see this. So now you see the code for the database is like source SQL database, it's from server, and you are pointing it to which schema and the table name. That's it. So what we need to do, whether we can take the entire script from here and replace it here? No, hold on. Basically, you need to check all the data types are correct. See, in this one, sales, ABC is a text, and session ID is numeric, sales date is date. So all these data types over here should have a same data type here. I mean, see, the session ID is text here, sales date is text here. So whatever you are going to replace, right, you ensure that the code it generates should also have a same data type. What will happen if the data type changes? Because here, based on this sales table, you have created some YTD, MTD calculations. All the things will collapse. Okay. So while getting the new source, ensure the data type in your old table and the new table is same. Now let us try to change the data types for these two. And this is nothing but change type, whole number, and I want this sales date to be date. Okay, now this looks fine. Okay, now let me take this script. Okay, then go to sales. Instead of Excel source, okay, the entire content, take the entire content, replace it with your database. Okay, now you're done. So this particular Excel source is replaced with database. What about product master? Product master is still, it's loading. I mean, this is your product master. Then take the entire script here. Let us try to see. The cost price is not numeric. See here, this is numeric, okay? I mean, sorry, cost price is numeric. Let us try to change the type to whole number. Okay, now you take the script of product. Now instead of this Excel source query, I'm replacing with the database source query. Now you are done. This is good. So now you have these two tables from the database. So do we need these two? No need. Either you can delete it, or for reference purpose or file troubleshooting you need it, just right click and enable load to uncheck it, so that it will not load in your power view. So let me uncheck the enable load. So these two tables, product sales data, won't be loaded. So these three tables will be loaded. So now once I click close and apply, so the changes will get applied. Now you see the loading data, and now you have these many rows, and you see this is from the database. Okay, now the data in the database, earlier in the navigated this report, we had data till 2016, 17, 18, 2019 it is empty. Now in the database I have populated 2019 data as well. Let us try to see the data. Okay, now there you go. See, 2018, 16, 17, I have data. OK, In what scenarios you will use this one? It's like you initially develop for a proof of concept using Excel or CSV files, and in production environment you need to go in different source system. It can be a database or SharePoint, anything. So in those scenarios you need to follow these steps. This is point number one. Another prerequisite is like, and or I can say it's an advantage of, is like you do not do any changes here, right? You have already created lot of modeling here. You create a number of measures over here. So once you have the same table name or the column names, and you no need to create anything new here. So that is one of the important thing you need to consider. Right, if you change the table name in the source, I mean instead of sales you say like sales transaction table, then this won't work, right? Entire thing will collapse. So ensure that all these things are prerequisite. How it works is like in the Power Pivot, right? I mean in the Power BI world, this modeling part is called Power Pivot, right? For the Power Pivot, Power Query gives the source. Okay, in the source, and there is in between Power Query and Power Pivot, there is a layer, right? It requires only the column name, the Power Pivot. So whatever in the source system, it can be Excel or it can be SharePoint, that is handled by Power Query. So for Power Pivot, it requires the column reference and the table name. So that is a thing I want to highlight. With this note, I hope you guys like this video and you learned how to change the source type. And share and subscribe to the channel. Comment below for your queries. Do remember that data is your asset.